Many people are claiming that Top Thrill 2 is rough, and to me that's crazy. How are people saying this before it even opens? Sure, it might rattle a little more than it should, but to call it rough is an overstatement. For you guys who don't know, Top Thrill 2 is a reincarnated Top Thrill Dragster. And with the first POV of Top Thrill 2 with Tony Clark and Mike Maney, people are already hating on this roller coaster. In this video, I'm going to tell you 5 reasons why Top Thrill 2 might be rough, and some reasons on how the haters might be wrong. The first and big reason why Top Thrill 2 might be rough or rattly is the high center of gravity. When comparing Top Thrill Dragster to King Dedeka, most people typically state how King Dedeka is much rougher than Top Thrill Dragster.
Now, King Dedeka's overall ride experience is rougher than Top Thrill Dragster's. Its launch isn't the smoothest.
I've had moments that are a bit janky, whereas Top Thrill Dragster's are more consistently smooth.
King Dedeka's launch is rough.
This is because of the high center of gravity King Dedeka's trains have. Top Thrill Dragster's lap bars had a lower center of gravity, keeping the ride smoother, while King Dedeka had over-the-shoulder restraints, much higher off the ground, causing the train to rattle back and forth. This applies to Top Thrill 2 as well. The New Zamperla Lightning trains have over-the-shoulder restraints, kind of like what you'll find out of a Lhasa coaster at Universal Islands of Adventure. Because it's over-the-shoulder restraints, that has a higher center of gravity, and with the new lightning trains being really light, the locking mechanism is most likely one of the heaviest parts of the train, causing it to rattle more. So that's just one reason why Top Thrill 2 could rattle. Notice I said rattle, not as rough. The second reason is old track. In the POV released by Cedar Point, you can see the train start rattling as soon as it goes up the top hat. Now this is not the only spot where it rattles, as you can see some rattling during the backwards launch. Now something you need to remember is rattling and vibrating are not the same thing. Every roller coaster vibrates, but Top Thrill 2's top hat rattles. Personally, I like it when a roller coaster rattles, as I feel like that makes it more intense. In the Top Thrill 2 POV, you can watch your bodies rattle a lot more when they reach the top hat. The reason the top hat is more rattly is because it's still the old track from Top Thrill Dragster from 2003. I believe that if Zamperla, the maker of Top Thrill 2, designed this, it would have been a lot smoother. And I'm not saying Intamin, the maker of Dragster, did a bad job making the track. I just think that the Zamperla Lightning trains don't ride as well on the Intamin track than they do on the Zamperla track. I don't see this becoming a future problem for anyone except Top Thrill 2 haters. The next three go hand in hand, but I'm going to explain why each one could make it look rough. Wind could play a huge factor in making it look rattly. I know the backwards POV of the riders showed them being rattled at the top hat, but the rest of the backwards POV looked good. Sure, there's a little rattleness on the pull up to the spike, but if you look past those 2 seconds, then I think you'll be fine. The reason it looks rattly is because of the wind. The old trains were heavier than the new lighter Zamperla Lightning train, which means wind affects it more. Speaking of the light trains, that's my 4th reason why Top Thrill 2 could be rough. In IAPA, Cedar Point and Zamperla showed off their new lightning trains. Credit to Amusement Insider. Zamperla talks about how their new train is made of carbon fiber. And carbon fiber can flex, and that's why it's so desirable for its high strength to weight ratio. With the train vibrating, the nose of the train is flexing back and forth, and I believe it's causing people to think that the entire train is flexing back and forth. And with a high speed on Top Thrill 2, 120 miles an hour, the aerodynamics are definitely playing a role in flexing the nose of the train. The 5th and final reason I think people assume Top Thrill 2 is rough is because of the speed. No matter how perfect a roller coaster is, the faster you go, the harder it is to be smooth. Millennium Force, also at Cedar Point, can look rough from the POVs, but when you're on it, it feels relatively smooth. The point of this video is to tell you guys to not judge Top Thrill 2 until you ride it. This is a big problem I've been seeing a lot. A lot of people are hitting on Top Thrill 2 just because they're biased that the old Dragster is gone. And that's something everyone should hear. Top Thrill Dragster is gone. And Top Thrill 2 is a new roller coaster. So let's judge it that way. There are many other reasons why Top Thrill 2 could look rough. For example, the POV. The POV on Red Forest at Ferrariland Port Aventura looks really rough. But many can agree that Red Forest is a really smooth roller coaster. I hope you guys get to experience Top Thrill 2 when it opens. It should be a great roller coaster. I hope you guys got a new perspective on Top Thrill 2, and if you did, let me know. And of course, thank you for watching.